punched Masha in the head, then told her he would kick her in the legs too. Masha became frightened and ran away. Masha ran to the co-op to hide behind the cash register. The manager saw Masha and asked, "What do you have there in your hands?" And Masha said, "A mushroom." The manager said, "Aren't you a sharp one? Do you want me to fit you up with a job?" Masha said, "You won't." The manager said, "I will too." And he fixed her up with the job of running the cash register. Masha kept running the register, and suddenly, she died. A militiaman came, wrote it all down, and ordered the manager to pay a 15-ruble fine. The manager asked, "Why should I have to pay a fine?" The militiaman said, "For murder!" The manager became frightened, paid the fine, and said, "Take this dead cashier away quickly, very quickly." But the salesman from the fruit department said, "No, that's not true. She was not the cashier. She only turned the handle on the cash register. The cashier's sitting over there." The militiaman said, "We don't care. We've been told to carry away the cashier, and we will carry her away." The militiaman went up to the cashier. The cashier lay down on the floor behind the cash register and said, "I'm not going." The militiaman said, "Why don't you come, you fool?" The cashier said, "You're going to burn me alive." The militiaman started to lift the cashier off the floor, but he could not lift her up because she was very fat. "Pull her out by her feet," said the sales clerk from the fruits department. "No," said the manager. "This cashier is sort of like my wife, so I ask you not to pull her clothes off down below." The cashier said, "Do you hear? Don't dare to pull my clothes off down below." The militiaman picked up the cashier under her arms and dragged her and threw her out of the co-op. The manager ordered the sales clerks to clean up the store and to start doing business. "What are we to do with a dead woman?" asked the sales clerk from the fruits department. "My God," said the manager, "we've got everything mixed up. Really, what should we do with a dead woman?" "We'll sit behind the cash register," asked the sales clerk. The manager clutched his head. With his knee, he knocked apples all over the counter and said, "This is terrible. Sales clerk said altogether. Suddenly, the manager stroked his mustache and said, "It's not so easy to stump me. We'll put the dead woman at the cash register. Maybe the public won't figure out who it is that is sitting behind the cash register." But they put the dead woman behind the cash register, stuck a cigarette between her teeth, and for the sake of verisimilitude, put a mushroom in her hand. The dead woman sat behind the cash register as though she were alive. Only the color of her face was very green. One eye was open and the other completely shut. "That's all right," said the manager. "She will do." The public was knocking at the door and getting very excited. Why was the co-op not opening up? One woman, especially in a silk coat, started shouting and shaking her bag and aimed a heel at the door handle. Behind her, an old woman with a pillowcase on her head shouted, swore, and called the manager of the co-op a scoundrel. The manager opened the door and let the public to each department, and then to where the sugar and pepper are sold. The old woman went at once to the fish department, but on her way looked up at the cashier and stared. Oh, she said, may the Lord bless us. With the woman in silk coat had already been in all the departments and headed for the cash register. But as soon as she looked at the cashier, she stopped, stood silently, and stared. The sales clerks were also silent and stared at the manager. The manager looked up from behind the counter to see what would happen next. The woman in the silk coat turned to the sales clerks and asked, who is that sitting behind your cash register? The sales clerks were silent because they didn't know how to answer. The manager was also silent. People gathered from all directions. There was a crowd in the street. Dawn appeared. Whistles were heard. In a word, a real sensation. The crowd was all set to stand around the co-op until nightfall. But somebody said that in Lamp Lane, an old woman was falling out of the window. So the crowd at the co-op thinned out because many people went over to